Hi, I'm Eric Lesser with Spyderco. I'm going to go over some of the new knives that we're revealing here at SHOT Show. Most of these knives will be coming out over the next couple months, and I'm excited to bring them to you. The first thing I'm going to start with are a lot of products that we were showing last year. These might have come out in the mid-year that we were starting to advertise, but haven't yet quite delivered, but they are soon on the horizon. I have about a dozen knives here, and we'll start to roll through it. The first one is a Dmitry Sinkevich. It's called the Drunken. This one we've kind of showed for about 6 months now. A beautiful design, holds very well. This comes with an S90V. It comes with a beautiful grind that leaves a little bit of thickness here at the top. It has a nice custom hardware, 3D carbon fiber. It's got an excellent pattern on here that kind of weaves through there. Dmitry calls it his drunken pattern. And it's on both sides, so it has a nice 3D machining with a beautiful pattern. Customized clip, customized backspacer. When you look on the inside, we even machined a web. It's got a stainless interface. It's also an over travel stop, so you're not going to overbend your lock. It's got ball bearings, so it just is absolutely beautiful in its action. It's very thin in its carry, but with also a nice stock size for the blade. In its carry and balance and beauty and manufacturing, it's a pleasure to get to work with Dmitry on the Drunken. And so this is the Drunken by Dmitry Sinkevich. The next one, I'm just going all out beautiful here. This is a Peter Rezenti. It's called the Paysan. It's got also custom hardware. It's got a nice thick stocked S90V blade. Again, like the Drunken, a beautiful piece. It's got a tapered solid titanium handle. It kind of tapers down a little bit, and it's also three-dimensionally machined. Very unique lanyard at the back. It's got a stainless interface here for the titanium. Also an over travel stop, so you're not going to overbend it. Again, it's got ball bearings. Our phosphor bronze ball bearing system is going to give you tremendous action. It's a beauty to work with. But in pure quality and design, we're excited to work with Peter Rezenti on it. He did a fantastic job with this knife. So this should be coming to the market soon. One that we're getting ready to ship this week. This is a design by Kevin Smock. It's called the Smock. This comes with a compression lock. That's where that metal goes between the stop pin and the blade. But on this compression lock, it's a button release. It's a nice addition to the compression lock. It also has a phosphor bronze ball bearing system. It has a nice front flipper here, so you don't have a big beak or something sticking out of the knife. It just goes in and out of the pocket very nicely. And for that flipper, it just works magnificently. It's got a nice strong tip, a nice grind here. Also, the hole is accessible on both sides. It's also reversible clipped. You know, when it comes up, it's G10 peel ply carbon fiber laminate. It's open construction. This is a gorgeous, gorgeous knife to work with, and we're excited to work with Kevin on this one. So this should be shipping this week. Now we're going to get into some fixed blades. The first one I'm going to show is designed by Phil Wilson. Phil Wilson's been making knives a long time. It's a beautiful knife maker. When you think of a Phil Wilson, oftentimes you think it fits the hand well. It's perfectly balanced. It has those nice full tangs. The bevel grinds are nice. You know, one of the things I love doing with a Phil Wilson is just feeling those thicknesses. It usually has a very thin edge. It's nice in its construction with a nice lanyard here in the back. It's got a great heat treat. And so this is a knife that's a value folder coming in from overseas. It's kind of MSRP for, I believe, about $65-$70. The quality is just gorgeous. And so when you buy this, you're going to feel like you're getting a Phil Wilson. It's going to cut like a Phil Wilson, but it's going to be at an amazing price. So getting the option to carry a Phil Wilson at this price is something we're excited about. The next one is designed by a Foramite, a junkie, a collector we've been working with named Lance Clinton. This is a knife that he developed. Lance Clinton does professional fishing. He's very good in his art. He goes out on a kayak and catches big fishes. It's an amazing job that he does. But through all of his artistry and his professionalism, he developed this knife for flaying, for everyday use, for a do-all, for the activity activities that he's looking for. And it really is. It is a beautiful carry fixed blade. It's got a full tang. Again, like a Phil Wilson, it's just gorgeously balanced. It's got a 3D G10 here that's got some texture. You're not going to be sliding around on this. It's got a great guard in the front. You're not going to slide down on it. It's got a full flat. It comes with LC200N. It's a extremely rust-resistant steel. And you'll see this is hardware-free. This isn't bolted together. It's got blind pins on the inside, and then we adhered and fastened everything together. So this handle's not going to come off. It's permanently put on there, and it's all just one beautiful, gorgeous piece. I have a sheath for this too. I like to show the sheath because this is a fold-over Boltron. So it's a nice fold-over. It's going to keep it a nice slim in the pocket. It's got that G-clip. You can fasten it all over the place for different types of carries. When it drops in, nice and snug. It's not rattling around. It's protecting the edge. Good thumb push-off. You know, the sheath is also a very important part of this design with all fixed blades, and we're proud to make this combination. This is in the U.S. facility, working with Lance Clinton. The next one I'm going to show are a couple buoys. A lot of these knives I was showing last year, but I like to continue to talk about them because they're so pretty. But I have two buoys here. One's designed by Jim Ankerson and Darren Sanders. The other's an in-house design. This one's called the Providence. This one's called the Respect. Both gorgeous, both buoys, but much different. For one, the thicknesses. This comes with a heavy stock of material. It's a CPM 154. Comes in 7mm thick. It's got that full flat grind, that nice guard, that 3D G10 handle, all bolted together, nice hidden tang, nice hook at the back. The Respect is going to bring a lot to the table. Also comes with a leather sheath, so it slides in. Little strap that goes over it. So the sheath is a beautiful sheath. Don't have one on me to show you, but the Respect is a USA made buoy. Very proud to be coming out with this one. And then the Ankerson, this one's a thinner stock. You're going to see it's got that 4mm thick, but this is a CPM M4, where this is CPM 154. So they're going to cut differently, they're going to react differently. You can go with typically a little bit thinner knife and get a lot of toughness with a CPM M4. And so, again, it's got a nice tall grind, it's thin, it's got a great tip. Both of these have great tips. It's got a nice flat top, so you can get all over the top for the different holding, a three-dimensional handle, bolt-together construction, a high polish, so it just feels beautiful in the hand. Hook in the back, lanyard, you know, this knife for hours of use. Both of these are just beautiful pieces to carry and use. So fixed blade buoys, totally excited about those. This is designed by a man named Paul Alexander. We call it the Parada. This comes with a stop lock, so the stop pin is here, and as you open it, the lock rotates and then snaps into place. Tremendously strong. So when you're using it, you'd have to break out the pin and everything to break this lock. So it gives you a lot of strength. The other thing is it's unlikely to open while during use. You got to lift the bar in order to unlock it. And so during use, you know, you'll be able to crawl all over this knife. It's going to do great. It's got a nice tall bevel there. It's got a lot of blade for handle ratio. When you pop it in your pocket with the wire clip, it's got a nice profile so that you're not scratching up your pocket. Nice and thin, open construction. You know, this is a new knife. Nothing's ever been done quite like it. And so we're excited for it. Nice big belly, nice guard, so you're not going to slide on it. So Paul Alexander created a neat design here. So these are all things that we haven't yet delivered, but we started the show last year, and that's one of the reasons we have the new reveal program. So now we have four items that I'm going to show you. These are all being revealed early this year, and then all these are planned to deliver soon. The first one is a Warren Cliff Endura, Endura 4. You know, people know the Endura. I like to always talk about it. It's got the bi-directional texturing. It's got the four-way clip. It's got screw-together construction. It's got a sturdy backlock. with a great reputation, great self-close, you know, snaps and replace, you know, the Endura, the Delica, these families of knives are, you know, a great testament in time of performance. They stand near the test of time. And so this one comes with a Warrencliff blade. One of the things you get with our Warrencliffs, we take a lot of pride in it, is that is a perfectly flat edge and the edge angles are perfect. Nice crisp tip. You know, we want this flat, we want those edge angles perfect, we want that tip crisp, and that's what makes a quality Warrencliff. And so, you know, when it comes to this nice full flat, this tapered blade and that perfect edge, we're very proud of our Warrencliff. So this is the Endura 4 Warrencliff. It'll come in plain and serrated. Then we have a new value folder. It's not new, it's the Efficient, but it's a variation of another knife, except for it's in all black. I know a lot of people have seen the Efficient. I like to continue to talk about it, though, because it's a great knife. You know, it has a left hand or a right hand open option. It has a clip that's reversible. When it's in your pocket, the profile is just slim. It's got full liners. It's got a backspacer here, so it's not the open construction, but it's going to give you weight, and it's going to give you something for your palm there. Some people like that little bit of extra. So if you're really using the knife, it gives you some nice weight to it. It's got that full flat grind, that double distal taper, that beautiful jimping, that 50 thou liner that locks up perfect. Though it's a value folder, in the world of value folders, we think it's one of the best out there. And so, you know, it's the Efficient. This will be coming out in black, 50-50, which is the plain serrated, plain edge combination. So various different combinations, but if you're looking for a good everyday carry value folder, the Efficient is about as efficient as you can get. The next ones, this one is a lightweight pair of three. This is coming out of the U.S. facility. We took a nice design of ours. It's been getting a good reputation for performance, the pair of three, and turned it into a nice lightweight package, reduced the cost a little bit. We added a BD1N blade. It's got a compression lock just like the classic. It's got a deep pocket wire clip. It's got bi-directional texturing. It's got an open back construction. This is just a lightweight, everyday carry beast made here in the U.S. As some quick side notes, the detail on this, beautiful. You know, you start getting into the world of ball detents, this has a little bit of self-close. It's great for the opening and closing, carrying in the pocket. And then when you open it, you hear that click, that nice, secure lock. This is what you want in a lightweight. I mean, it feels confident when you're using it, and you should be confident. It's going to perform for you. So this is the lightweight pair of three. I'm excited to bring that to the market. And then we have another design by Paul Alexander. This is called the Ikuchi. A lot like the Smock, this uses a front flipper type mechanism. You don't have something big protruding out of your pocket when you're going in and out. You don't have, you know, that beak or that kicker. And so it's rotated up towards the front. This uses a little bit of jimping, and you can rotate it. See, I'm just kind of rotating it. Or you could rotate it with your thumb, and then when you let it go, it just shoots right open. This also uses a compression lock. The compression lock works great for flippers, nice open construction, phosphor bronze ball bearing system, deep pocket clip, G10 peel ply carbon fiber. It's a new beauty in design. We're excited to work with Paul on this one. And this one's called the Ikuchi. Now, all of the knives I've reviewed should be hitting the market fairly soon. That's why we're doing this new reveal program. You shouldn't have to wait too long. And we're going to be adding a new sharpener to our line. We do make some of the best sharpeners out there, like the Sharpmaker, the 204MF. Still classic, not going away. If it's not one of the best, it's certainly up there. This is going to be a little bit simpler. This is going to be more of a countertop sharpener. It's going to come with these what we call cat's eye ceramic stones. They're going to have a tighter radius for doing tight teeth, more like on a kitchen knife or the smaller serrations. It'll still do a bigger serration. You know, it has that tight radius to get in and out of each tooth. This is going to do a kitchen knife very well. And so with this sharpener, you're going to have a nice guard here. If you're new to sharpening, you know, you can feel nice and secure with this guard. It's going to give you a good feeling. And then just like our regular sharpeners, you go from heel to tip all the way down it. Tremendously easy to use. High ceramic, high quality ceramic stones. It's a good quality piece. And then you can also get some CBN stones that go with it if you really need to hog out a lot of material. These cut quick. They can hog it out. And then when you are done, if you do want, you can still slide these stones away, so it's a smaller package. Though it's not intended to be as much as a field sharpener like our Sharp Maker, it's a nice addition to a nice countertop. It gives you a little bit more length for the stone for a bigger blade. It's just a new addition to our sharpening line that already seems to be a pretty good line. And so I hope the gauntlet finds a way for you. And thank you very much for checking out some of our product. We're excited about it, and I hope you are too.